Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is ChrisGamer1025, and we are back here tonight, live for CJM. And I'm told that we have a pretty important announcement here tonight at the start of the show. I don't know exactly what it is, but we shall see about that. We're live at Fairfax, Virginia, is the home for CJM here tonight. As we're going to run down through the card here, only three matches are set up as of right now. We'll see if that changes later. The first one, hopefully Ruby Soho will take on Ivy Nile here tonight. We're finally getting that match. Next, we're going to get Tenille Dashwood versus the returning Athena here tonight. I can't wait to see that. And another one I can't wait to see, the main event, it'll be Roosh versus Solo Sikoa. Both men that debuted at Cyber Sunday will be taking on each other tonight. Without further ado, let's head over to ringside right now. And guys, we're here live. Hold on a second. Guys, wait a minute. That's the chairman of CJM and Pure Wrestling, the CEO of CJM and Pure Wrestling. He's here tonight. What the hell? What the hell is... What's happening here? And here he comes. Such a rare appearance by Vince McMahon here on CJM. It's been a long time since I've seen the CJM and Pure Wrestling universe, and I'm glad that you're all here in attendance tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I, Vince McMahon, is retiring from all my duties in CJM and Pure Wrestling. And with that being said, let me introduce to you the person that will take my spot to run CJM and Pure Wrestling, to be overseeing all the operations. Huh? Oh my! No freaking way! Guys! You're looking at him! The return of Shane O'Mac! Shane McMahon is in the building! Shane McMahon is here! Shane McMahon! I can't believe it! I'm in shock right now, guys! And Shane McMahon! Here we go! We're gonna see him here tonight! Fairfax, Virginia! Welcome to CJM! And let me just say, I am very, very excited, very happy for this opportunity. Shane, oh wait, hold on. I didn't say you were alone. What? What are you talking about? Ladies and gentlemen, the co-CEO along with Shane McMahon and the chairwoman of CJM and Pure Wrestling, Stephanie McMahon. What? Did I just hear what he think he said? Did he just say? He did. Ladies and gentlemen, Stephanie McMahon is in the building. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Stephanie McMahon is here. And she is the chairwoman. Shane McMahon and Shane McMahon is just in shock right now. I mean, hell, I would be too. I mean, I think maybe Vince. And this is absolutely insane. I mean, this is, I don't even have words. Steph, I think it's the perfect time that we get out of here so we can let Dad say goodbye to the universe. Thank you for an incredible four seasons of CJM and Pure Wrestling. You guys are the best fans I could have ever asked for. And tonight, I leave you with change. Thank you. Good for Vince McMahon soaking the moment here tonight. Jam-packed crowd. What? What is Triple H doing out here? It looks like he wants to congratulate and he wants to say thank you Vince's father-in-law to Vince McMahon. And my God, I can't believe what I'm seeing right now. Triple H walking down the ramp here tonight, looking to confront Vince. And ladies and gentlemen, he's going to have a few words for Vince. This has to be emotional for both men here tonight. The fact that these two... Oh my God! What? What? You're kidding! Oh my pedigree! Triple H has just given the pedigree right to Vince McMahon, the former CEO and chairman of C.J.M. Pure Wrestling. And he's walking out of here! I can't believe it! This is how we're going to start the show! Holy hell! And here we go tonight, Fairfax, Virginia. As it looks like we're going to kick things off here with Imperium coming out. And here they are, ladies and gentlemen. Imperium are coming out here tonight. We shall see what they have to say and definitely what their actions are going to be. I mean, we know that Walter faced Roman Reigns for the C.J.M. Championship, and Fabian Nightmare and Marcel Bartel faced the Usos for the United Tag Team Championships, obviously unsuccessful in both those opportunities for all three of these men. But tonight, it seems like they're walking down the ring with confidence. I mean, hey, Walter, big win against Tony Nese on C.J.M., and tonight, it looks like they will address the universe to see exactly what is going to become of them next. And there you see it, the ring general here tonight. Walter definitely leading the pack here. You know that he thinks very highly of himself. As all three men, the image alone of all of these men in the ring just strikes you as powerful. And we all can see that. The look on these men's faces as they are prepared for tonight, whatever comes their way. I mean, they're in their wrestling attire. They are here to wrestle. So let's just see. Tony Nese lost to Walter, and he's upset, and he's now obsessed with trying to beat Walter, trying to beat Imperium. So let's go. Come on, Nese. Let's go, Premier Athlete. We're waiting for you. You're kidding me. And guys, wait a minute. Here he is. What? What? His partner is Smart Mark Sterling? And Smart Mark Sterling, he's hyped to be out here. Tony Nese has found himself a partner, and it seems like it's his own manager. Well, he's not an in-ring competitor, but he'll do. The Premier Athlete leading the charge against Imperium. And looks like Smart Mark Sterling's excited to be out there here tonight. I can't wait to see how this match is gonna go. My God, is Mark Sterling gonna impress the hell out of us? We shall see about that. Tony Nese, is this a wise choice or what? I have no idea. We're gonna have to find out right here, right now. Here, Tony Nese, he's that pissed that he's recruited Smart Mark Sterling to be his tag team partner tonight. And this match is actually a thing. This matchup is actually happening. Tony Nese and Smart Mark Sterling versus Marcel Bartel and Fabian Aichner. I am just so, oh my goodness. Tony Nese, obviously he's not thrilled of that loss that he took. And look at this, Smart Mark Sterling already getting involved. Oh no. Well, looks like Smart Mark Sterling, hey, he's got a little bit of offense, but you need to leave the ring here. His attire is questionable, though, I would say that. His attire is very questionable. But hey, Tony Nese, if he's finding success in having Smart Mark Sterling as a partner tonight and getting a win, might as well go for it. And a tag to Marcel Bartel. Tony Nese now, oh, in a predicament. There's a jawbreaker there. And now, oh, going for the arm to take him right down. Oh no, that doesn't look good at all. And now Marcel Bartel already going for a submission hold here tonight. And no, Torinese escapes right out of it. And oh, what a powerful headbutt there. Oh, hold on a minute. Small Mark Sterling gets tagged in. Wait a second. Oh no, he gets punched in the face automatically. Oh man, missile drop kick. And of course, Mark Sterling, he's just a manager. He has a managerial role. He doesn't wrestle as frequently. Oh no. Oh. That's why, I don't know, man. When he gets in there, I don't know if we are exactly going to see a five-star matchup. Oh, what a kick to the face. And again, just disrespectful here tonight. And oh, what an overhand chop. Oh, let's see what he's got. Hell, you might not want to knock him here tonight after seeing his wrestling ability. Who knows? Small Mark Sterling might put on one hell of a show. And I think he's toying with Fabian Aichner here tonight. Fabian Aichner's just like, man, are you serious? Hold on. Wait a minute. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Oh, my. What a takedown. Right to the floor. Right onto the floor, Small Mark Sterling. Oh, is he gonna mess with Walter? What the hell? He's gotta be out of his mind. He's gotta be out of his mind. If he's gonna mess with the ring general here tonight, look at building some offense for himself tonight. Hold on, Small Mark Sterling, getting those punches. Oh no. Oh, well, it was good while it lasted. Oh, wait, maybe I spoke too soon. No, never mind. Oh, as he gets thrown down. Like I said, he's not used to this type of environment. Oh, no, 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 no. Suplex on the outside. Wait. Mark Sterling, German suplex right on the floor here tonight. And a count of seven. He's going to get back inside the ring. Oh, he's attacking Marcel Bartel. Oh, missile drop kick, leaving no room for Fabian Aichner to make a tag here tonight. But I don't know if that's going to be smart here. Hold on. Oh, kick right to the back. And Tony Nieces, man, he's just, I know you can't see him on this camera angle, but he's reaching his hand out for a tag, desperately telling Sterling to get out of the ring right now. And a tag made right to Bartel. And I don't know what are we going to see here tonight. These men are just fighting for position. Oh, no. Oh, no. I don't think he wants to do that. Don't get up. Sterling, look out. Oh, another missile drop kick right down to Mark Sterling. And look at this, a tag made right to Nice. Nice now going to go in it. No, knee right to the gut. Springboard, what? Springboard crossbody from Marcel Bartel. That's unique. But thank God Nice has finally got a tag. Double foot stomp. And oh, he missed that one there. Tonight he rolled out of the way. And look at this, Nice getting some offense. Gets a swing, missed it. Get the knee right to the face. And a running boot. And oh, a huge cartwheel kick tonight. Nice is on fire. Holy hell. I didn't think he could do this to Marcel Bartel, but he's doing it. Look at this, the strength of Tony Nice, the premier athlete. He's gonna do it again. He's gonna do it again. Oh my goodness. I don't even know how he finds the strength to do this here tonight. And now a cover. One, and a kick out, man. Unlucky there for the premier athlete. As ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you, tonight we're live, Fairfax, Virginia, for tonight's CJM. It has been such an incredible and an impactful show thus far, and we're gonna witness more tonight. Oh, beautiful moonsault, beautifully executed. Fabian Aichner breaks it up, and Nice is gonna throw him right to the outside. This leaves a window of opportunity for Mark Sterling and Tony Nice. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Mark Sterling and Nice might win this one in the bag. Angry after suffering a loss to Walter, we heard from him, from the man himself. He vows to take revenge against Imperium tonight. Look at that leg sweep. That combination, that comeback. And now, Nice 450. A move that's won him many a matches. Nice wants Sterling to finish it off, and so Fabian Aichner. Fabian Aichner gets also tagged in as well. Oh my, there goes Nice. And Aichner gonna throw him to the corner of Imperium right now. And now, oh my god, we're gonna, oh no, Imperium, they have them set up. We already know what's coming. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. European uppercut, powerbomb. My goodness. And here we go, the cover. One, two, and it's over. Man, and Morris, props to Mark Sterling. And look at this, Walter just in the ring celebrating with Aichner and Marcel Bartel over the win. Man, like I said, props to Sterling. He's normally not an in-ring competitor, but him and Nice did the damn thing here tonight. And look, here tonight we're back for more action. And here is women's action coming your way. Ruby Soho, ladies and gentlemen, as she will face Ivy Nile. Ruby Soho and Deonna Purrazzo were evaluated after getting attacked by Ivy Nile, especially Ruby Soho with that sleeper that she put on her. And well, look at Deonna Purrazzo accompanying Ruby Soho to the ring. They had a banger of a match and were about to shake hands and show respect. But unfortunately, Ivy Nile interrupted everything. And well, now you see it here tonight. Ivy Nile will take on Ruby Soho. And just to avoid complications, Deonna Purrazzo will be at ringside, as I'm sure Roderick Strong will be at ringside for Ivy Nile's match tonight. And here she is. Man, let's talk about Ivy Nile. Her presentation is impressive. She is jacked, and I mean, she's one of the most strongest women I've ever seen here in all of CJM. And tonight, she is gonna be in her first matchup. It looks like she's ready and she's prepared here tonight. I won't doubt that. I mean, look at this. She's gonna head for the win. She got those chains around her neck. Roderick Strong accompanying her to the ring. I'm pretty sure the Creed brothers are looking on as well. And here we go. A referee's gonna ring the bell. Let's do this thing here tonight. As a Ruby Soho, oh, going for some kicks in the beginning here tonight. As I'm sure right here, the runaway Ruby Soho will take her revenge on Ivy Nile here tonight. As Roderick Strong, he definitely wants to make sure that he sees a lot of improvement in Ivy Nile, as Ruby Soho, she's just, you know, destroying the fingers of Ivy Nile. Oh, what a strong punch she missed as Ruby Soho countered that one. But no, trying to drag her somewhere. Ivy Nile is gonna deny that. Oh, there's that punch. And now it's Ruby Soho's turn to get out of harm's way. Big right forearm there, and now, oh, crucifix. Thought I was gonna go for the cover, but no. I think she feels like it's a little too early for that. Hold on, running drop kick right to the back. And now going for the arm yet again, just focusing her attack on that. And that's very smart. Oh, senton, no, Ivy Nile countered that senton. And oh my God, what a punch to the face. Right to Ruby Soho. Look at the punishment. The damage has been dealt with here tonight. As we can see, Ivy Nile, she's, oh my goodness, going for Ruby Soho's arm. And oh, those double knees right to the back. Always impressive here tonight. And again, she's going to try to destroy Ruby Soho here tonight. And oh no, again, going to use those double knees to her advantage right after this move. My God. I believe she's attacking the same arm. Oh, and again. As Ivy Nile, oh man, going for a knee right to the face. And still trying to make sure she's down and out. And does she have a submission hold? That grip on that shoulder blade there, the collarbone. Oh man, Ruby Soho, wait a minute, off the ropes. Senton there, she hit that one. And oh, big elbow shot, Ivy Nile. It seems like the crowd is really in Ruby Soho's favor. She gets out of the fireman's carry. Ruby Soho now, STL, beautiful here tonight. And look at this, back suplex, hit it right on the mark. Oh, kick to the face, right to the side of the head. And hold on, twisting the leg inside out. I think that's very smart. Oh, what a kick to the face there. And now, big punch. No, looks like those punches are not going to be taking place here. Whoa, right to the outside. Big forearm shot, and here we go. Oh, man. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Oh, punishment being added to Soho here tonight. Those clubbing blows right to the chest. Oh, man. And she almost falls on Deonna Purrazzo here tonight. And she almost fell on her. I mean, that would have been a... Oh, goodness. That would have been a whole another story there. But now, just playing with Ruby Soho tonight. As there you see it, she's going to go for the arm again. Same arm here tonight. Will she put Ruby Soho to sleep, or will she get a pinfall victory? Oh, hell, I might be getting too ahead of myself. Maybe Ruby Soho might get a win. Oh, my. Right to the steps. Right to the steps she goes as referee counts 7 here. As Ivy now already knows what to do, gets back inside the ring. She thinks she's going to get this one off a count out. I doubt that. As a count of 9, Ruby Soho, she was just catching her breath. She needed to. Oh, right hand, no. Oh, Ruby Soho with the counter. Soho now, STO. STO taking her down. Oh, my top rope. Oh, my goodness. That top rope springboard moonsault. What a takedown. Just, you could see that she is pissed off here tonight. Ruby Soho very pissed. And now she's still going to go for the neck. If you ask me, I think that's a smart thing to do here. As what does she have in mind? Wait, no. Irish whip to the corner. Big right hand and a knee and another one as she... Oh my God, and look at this. Oh man, a running corner drop kick. And now Ivy Nile. Oh, don't tell me she's going to go for the... Oh, no. Oh, that dastardly submission hold. The Dragon Slayer, as it is preferably called. And Ruby Soho struggling here tonight. And I think Ruby Soho is just going to tap out. That's the only option she really has here. Ivy Nile with an, of course, impressive victory tonight. Laughing at her and telling her that she's next. Ivy Nile is celebrating with her first victory in her debut match here tonight in CJM. Man, Soho tapped out, man. Impressive. Impressive here tonight is Ivy Nile representing Diamond Mine. No, no, no. You people don't get to sit there and applaud the show without the villain being the true USA Champion. Well, guys, it looks like Marty Scurll interrupting the evening here, saying that he's the rightful USA champion, and he has his wrestling gear on. You know what? You people are disgusting. You don't see the real picture. I made that championship. Let me ask you this question. Are you guys really interested in Flip Gordon? Flip Gordon has always been a nobody. Flip, come out here in the middle of this ring, and let's have a rematch. Whoa, 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 Marty. Well, you're coming out here, you want a rematch. Didn't you just hear what our new management just said? Let's face it, Marty, you tapped out. You know what, Flip? Shut your mouth and just walk down here. No, it doesn't work that way. You see, Marty, if you beat this man here tonight, you'll get another championship match. All right, let's do this. Bring him out. Let's go. Oh, guys, it seems like Flip Gordon has joined us on commentary. Oh, man. Marty Scurll, oh, you better be ready. Here he comes. Johnny Elite. Johnny Elite making his first in-ring appearance here. His first matchup back with the brand in quite some time. Johnny Elite is definitely a game changer. And oh boy, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it. If Marty Scurll defeats Johnny Elite tonight, he will receive another rematch at the next pay-per-view, which is a Backlash for the USA Championship against Flip Gordon. Now, let's be honest. Do you want to see the match for a third time? Not me. I'm sure as hell not for it. But Marty has a unique opportunity to make that happen. And Marty is definitely elated for tonight's match. Here we go. The bell has rang. And ladies and gentlemen, joining me on commentary is none other than the USA champion himself, Flip Gordon. Flip, now, what's your comments about Marty Scurll? Oh my God, has he cracked the fingers of Johnny Elite? Well, listen, I mean, definitely that submission match was a hard-fought match. I have nothing but respect for Marty Scurll, but, you know, this matchup right here, I don't think he's going to win in this predicament. Oh, so you're predicting Johnny Elite to win. That's what you're saying right now here. Yep, I'm predicting Johnny Elite to win. Honestly, Marty Scurll, as a leader he was, he did teach me a lot. And I used all the tools to beat him here. I mean, beat him at Cyber Sunday, I should say. You definitely did, as let's get back to the action. Missing that elbow drop, Marty Scurll now has full control of Johnny Elite tonight. I mean, yeah, Johnny Elite, I mean, he surprised me when he came to the save at Cyber Sunday. I mean, I had no idea that that man was going to come at all. You're right, and oh my, we're going to see a gory bomb there by Marty Scurll. Now, Flip, I mean, what do you think of Johnny Elite as a competitor? He was a former USA champion in his own right. Hold on. Oh, vicious powerbomb. Yeah, I mean, he was definitely a USA champion, but for a short amount of time, I feel like Johnny Elite definitely needed more time to shine, and I feel like maybe it's his time this time around here for the brand, and, you know, hopefully down the road, I would want to definitely face him in a USA Championship match. Well, that's a very bold statement. Very, very smart of you to say there, Flip. As these two men are now on the outside, as, oh no, Johnny Elite brings things back in the inside, and I think that's very smart here tonight. What I don't think it's smart is Marty Scurll wrestling, knowing damn well that literally he faced you, Flip Gordon, he faced Flip at Cyber Sunday in a submission match. I don't know how that's going to benefit him here tonight. And I definitely think Marty might be at risk here. Oh, hold on. Oh, Death Valley driver there. And now going for the cover. Not even a two count. Well, listen, Chris Cash, I'll tell you this. Definitely, you know, I see both these men as tough competition. And regardless of the fact of what you want to say about Marty Scurll, even if you don't have any respect for him, he's one hell of a competitor. And he knows how to pull out the stops when nobody else thinks he can. Oh, what a heel kick there. Did you see that, Chris? Yeah, I definitely saw that right there. And now Flip Gordon goes back inside the ring. But no, you're definitely right. Hold on, what are we going to see? Oh, looks like a huge rolling type maneuver there. And now Johnny, oh, Man, Johnny's just been impressive. Oh, hold on. Anaconda Vice here tonight. Went to Marty Scurll. Is Marty Scurll going to tap out? No, no. Knees right to the back. Marty Scurll is a very gifted technical wrestler. 100%. I would agree on that. Yeah, you know, I definitely would say that, Flip. You know, he definitely knows how to escape from a lot of submission holds. Yeah, and I definitely would say a lot of wrestlers can try to outmatch him. Oh my, what a knee! My goodness, sorry, Flip, to interrupt, but did you see that? Yeah, I can't even believe it. That knee is very impactful. I mean, huge knee right there on the outside. But who knows? I mean, this matchup can end any way we want. Oh, well, right into the step goes the villain here. And now, Johnny Elite. He might have, what the hell? Over the steel steps? No way in hell. What? Oh my God! Hurricane run on the outside. Over the steps onto the floor. Oh, and I think he hit the steps there a little bit. Hold on. What the hell are we gonna, oh man. Right onto the floor, man. At least he got up there. And Flip, let me ask you, I mean, what's the game plan? Oh, wait, springboard. Oh! Roundhouse kick. Marty Scurll was too busy being cocky there. What's the game plan if you do face a guy like Johnny Elite? Oh, snapping the fingers. Well, I would say the game plan would be to keep him grounded. I know he's very agile. He loves to go to the top rope, and he loves to pull off that Starship Pain. And I would say definitely those things I would keep in mind. Oh, that's very smart. Look, I think Marty's trying to take a page off of what you just said, attacking the leg and rubbing the boot against the face of Johnny here tonight. Man, will we see a crossface chicken wing in Johnny Elite's near future right here tonight? Kick to the midsection. Oh, as he drags him along the ropes. Such a dirty tactic by Marty Scurll. Hold on. Powerbomb again. Right to the canvas. And oh, wait a minute. He's got that knee bar. No, I don't think Johnny Elite's going to tap. I definitely don't think Johnny Elite is going to be doing that here tonight. See, I told you, Chris. I told you. Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, for a second there, it looked like he was going to tap out. Oh, Johnny switching positions. Very smart. Look out, springboard. Knee to the face. We've seen that move end badly. But Johnny Elite nails it. Sweeps of the leg. Whoa. And, man, I forgot the offense that this man brought to the table, brought to the dance here in C.J.M. as Marty Scurll kicks out. He definitely thought that was a three count. Hold on. Johnny Elite. What the hell? What the hell was that? I've never seen that before in my life. And there you see it. Johnny Elite picking up the victory against Marty Scurll. And Johnny Elite obviously just pinning the former USA champion, and that's huge. And even Flip knows that that's a huge, huge victory. But what does that mean for the USA championship? I don't know. And Marty Scurll, oh my God, he's eyeing Johnny Elite. Wait, Flip Gordon, he just took off the headset and he's just now making a beeline for the ring. Look out now. And look, oh, Marty Scurll, oh, with the big right hand. And now again, using the, wait a minute. Flip, oh, he took out the knees and a super kick right in position. And Flip Gordon, oh my God, 450. What a splash there from Flip Gordon here tonight, saving Johnny Elite. And look at this. These two men meeting in the middle. I'm pretty damn sure Johnny Elite is grateful for that. But tonight, it was all about taking out Marty Scurll. And believe me, ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Elite had a huge win here tonight in CJM, and I think Flip sees that. More women's action, and guess what, guys? Tonight will be the first night we'll be seeing Athena back in action. As here is the Influence coming out first here tonight. Tenille Dashwood will be in action as she'll take on Athena tonight in Athena's first match back. And it's actually Athena's first match in CJM. We will see how she'll fare. She did send a message to Naomi, our female takeover champion. And Tenille Dashwood, well, she's not too happy about it. We caught up with her backstage and she said that she wants to stop the momentum of Athena. We shall see about that. And here she is, guys. The fallen goddess herself, Athena, as the crowd is blowing the roof off this place for her tonight. Athena here tonight, man, new look and everything you saw here. She came prepared, looking a little different from her old gear and her hair as well and everything, the presentation. Man, I remember, man, you're looking at a former women's wrestling champion right here, which I did mention at Cyber Sunday. Everyone has missed her here, the CJM and Pure Wrestling Universe, but guess what? She is back. And looks like the fans are pumped and ready to see her here tonight. I can't wait as well, but hey, let's not count out Tenille Dashwood. She might have a chance to knock her off here tonight. Here we go here, ladies and gentlemen. Look out. Tenille Dashwood, former APW Women's Champion. And look at this. Look out. Oh! Northern Lights there. Very smart. Very smart. Look out. Oh, elbow drop. No, she missed that one. As another Northern Lights suplex there. Going for the cover this time. But Athena with the kick out. And, oh, she almost went for that overhand chop. And here we see Athena gonna bring her up and gonna swing her down right down to the canvas. Going already for the cover. Tenille, oh, kick out at one. Man, Tenille playing a very smart here tonight. Oh, missed that kick. Tenille is going to definitely fire back here tonight. Hold on now. Going to try to choke her out in the corner. Looks like she's going to try to do that here tonight. Man, all that momentum that she has here, I definitely feel that Tenille Dashwood is tough competition. Look out. Oh, what an elbow shot. Big kick. And now, oh, she's got her up. She's got her up. Fireman's carry. Oh! Gonna choke her on the ropes there. And, I mean, Athena better watch out. I mean, Naomi has been having a good reign as champion. To eye her the first night you come back? I don't know. I don't know if that's wise. Looks like she's wiping off the ring rust here tonight against Tenille Dashwood. And Tenille again. Look at this. And Madison Rayne is liking what she's seeing with the smile on her face. And gonna go for that arm. I'm trying to break the arm of Athena here tonight. And, oh! Just gonna lay it on her right there. Going for the leg as well. And now, oh, again. And she's not even letting Athena have a chance to breathe here. She focuses on the leg. And very smart tactic there, very smart. Hold on, hold on, cross arm bar here. She looks to break the arm here tonight. And no, Athena getting out of it. And now, gonna have her. No, Athena recovers. Now what she's having, oh my goodness, what a slam. And oh my, missed that one, oh, miscalculation. But nonetheless, she recovers. And now, going for that arm very quickly here tonight. Hold on. Athena has a plan here, wait a second. What can we see? Oh my goodness, hesitation, dropkick from the top. A huge front missile dropkick, as other people like to refer it as. And oh, going for that knee, very smart. Oh, went for that roundhouse, but again missed it. Tenille, clothesline, goes for the cover, trying to take her off guard in her first match back. Will it? No. Like a 2.8, 2.7. Oh, missed that one. Got the roundhouse to the midsection. Going for the back kick and another one. My goodness, the combination. Hey, wait a second. Madison Rayne, come on. Madison Rayne messing with the turnbuckle padding, and the referee is distracted here tonight. You gotta be kidding me. Come on. Look at this. Look at this. Submission hold. Submission hold here by Athena. Athena's gonna try to make Tenille tap tonight. But oh, Tenille with the back elbow shot. Definitely getting out of it. Hold on. Wait a minute. Athena, what is she thinking? Oh, right to the skull. Hey, wait. Madison Rayne just brought a chair into the ring. What the hell? Hopefully that doesn't affect the match as we see Athena on a roll. Clothesline, no, caught her. And goes on the apron. Big right hand there by Tenille. Tenille, oh my, springboard. Ah, it's a gurry. Looked like she knocked her out. She looked like she knocked Tenille out right there. Float, wait, float over. DDT. Madison Rayne, I don't think her chair plan is working as she would have liked it to. Hold on. Elbow drop. Very huge elbow drop there by Tenille. Very smart play there. Coming off of the top. And now, oh, going for that kick to the midsection. And now taunting right into the corner. She goes for that splash in the corner. Not good for Athena in that seated position. Oh my. And here she goes, Tenille. Wait, oh my God. There goes Tenille. Down she goes. And Athena looked like she just paid homage to you know who. Here we go. Oh my goodness. The most impressive move in professional wrestling. Athena with the victory here tonight. Incredible. Well, Tenille didn't see it coming. Athena getting up and out of nowhere hit that big spine buster and took Tenille out. What a win for the returning Athena. Oh, guys, wait a minute. Naomi. Naomi's here. Wait, that's Tamina. Tamina. Clothesline. Ow. Spanish fly. Athena caught it. Athena caught it. Oh, my God. Wait a minute. Are we going to see? No way. To Tamina! Oh my God! Sending a message right to Naomi! Oh guys, oh my, here we go! Whoa, what? Wait, what's going on here? And look at the shocked face of Athena and Naomi! What's going on? She has a microphone! I can't believe it. Oh, whoa, what? What? Miss Money in the Bank. Miss Money in the Bank. Thunder Rosa's back. She's back. No, but Bailey, you gotta be kidding me. Bailey is injured. She just said it. Oh, no. There's no way. No. Oh, my God. Naomi's in shock. Oh, my God. Oh, she caught her. Oh my God, Athena! And look at this type of stare down here tonight. Thunder Rosa and Athena. It's my turn to take the page of Marty Scurll's playbook and interrupt the show tonight. Oh boy, obviously Austin Theory upset that he was unsuccessful in trying to cash in the briefcase. He still has it, but he was unsuccessful in it, even starting the matchup. Now, the reason why I'm here tonight is that I want to call out CM Punk. Get your ass out here right now so I can tell you and show you who the best in the world really is. Austin Theory not backing down. Well, it looks like CM Punk is going to come out here tonight. CM Punk, there he is. You know, this man costed Austin Theory the whole chance. And well, he's going to walk down. And here he comes, CM Punk, here tonight. So you want to cost me my world championship shot, huh? Well, let me explain, Austin Theory, right? First of all, you want to come out here and say that you're the best, and you always want to throw jabs at Johnny Gargano when you know he's not even here to defend himself. That's why you're picking on him, right? Because he's not here. Well, guess what? Guess what, Theory? I'm here, and I'm here to tell you that I'm going to get in this ring, and we're going to do this right here tonight. All right, then, let's go. Come on. And you know what? What the hell? What? What's going on here? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Baron Corbin and Kevin Owens. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? This guy's telling Kevin Owens and Corbin to hold CM Punk up. Hey, wait just a damn minute. That's Hangman Adam Page. Hangman, big boot to Baron Corbin. And look at this. Oh, my God. Buckshot Lariat out by Hangman. Oh, look. Oh, my God. What a damn dropkick there from Theory as he's just now punishing Hangman Adam Page. Oh, my God. And Hangman Adam Page with that Buckshot Lariat to Kevin Owens. And now, oh, no. He's going to drop a Maytown down right here in the center of the ring. That's Ciampa. That's Ciampa. And I don't think Austin Theory realizes. Oh, boy. Austin Theory, turn around, Theory. Turn around. Oh, no. Look at this. Fairy tale ending right to Austin Theory. You see, Theory, one thing you might have forgotten is that you upset a lot of people around here. And as a matter of fact, looks like we have ourselves allies. So let's do this. A six-man tag team match. You bring your buddies right there, Kevin Owens and Baron Corbin, against me, Tommaso Ciampa, and Hangman Adam Page next week. This is absolutely insane. We're going to witness a six-man tag team match next week here on CJM. I am so pumped for that. And guys, here we are, your main event. And the main event will include this man right here, Roosh, taking on Solo Sikoa, two brand new wrestlers, two brand new superstars that have came to the brand. And of course, he's accompanied by Andrade El Idolo, the man that competed at Cyber Sunday against Roman Reigns for that CJM championship. And well, it's like I said, guys, the whole time he knew that, of course, Roman Reigns was gonna bring backup. So he brought his backup to Cyber Sunday. Well, Solo Sikoa has now joined the Bloodline, and it seems like Andrade El Idolo and Roosh are outnumbered. You got Roman Reigns, you got the Usos, Naomi, Tamina, and now Solo Sikoa? Not to mention Paul Heyman as a special counsel? Guys, like, come on. And look at him right here. Looks like Paul Heyman's hyping him up here tonight. Solo Sikoa. Of course, we knew that this man was going to come out. And we know that he was going to represent. Of course, he is definitely a part of the Bloodline. We know all the family tree, and Solo Sikoa is a big part of it. And the Usos are very proud to have him here. And so is Roman Reigns. Everybody in the Bloodline supports Solo Sikoa and his decision in joining. They says it is a part of his legacy. And almost costing Andrade El Idolo the whole match until Roosh came out and took him out. At least Roosh helped clean up the mess that was what happened at Cyber Sunday. But Andrade is lucky that he came prepared. As Solo Sikoa, of course, taking a little page off Roman Reigns' book. Let's see exactly who will come out on top. This is, to me, this is an unpredictable match here tonight, and I don't know who's going to walk away with the W, but we're going to see. Will it be Roosh or Solo Sikoa? Here we go. I'm excited to see these brand new stars rise to the occasion tonight. Oh, already hitting the referee in a quick second. Oh, Samoan drop there by Solo Sikoa. And now Roosh in trouble. Solo Sikoa heading up to the top. And now, oh, double axe handle there. Seems like Roosh was a little dazed. He didn't really try to take down Solo Sikoa from the top. And guys, as you notice, Solo Sikoa does not wrestle in boots and shoes or nothing. He's completely barefoot out there. Kind of reminds me of Matt Riddle's type of style, but will that affect him? We know it doesn't affect Riddle because all his years of practice in this wrestling ring, and Solo Sikoa, he's more brand new to the wrestling company than Riddle. So we shall see if it'll affect him tonight as he hits those headbutts right on Roosh. Oh, man. And there we go, going for the arm there. Solo Sikoa, look at this. Oh, no. There's Roosh with the counter. Double foot stop for Roosh. No. Solo Sikoa escapes. Roosh now is going to get caught. And another Samoan drop right there tonight. Roosh trying to recover. Running clothesline. No. Gets caught. Irish whip to the outside. Has him on the apron. But gets an enziguri right to the floor. And Paul Heyman just looking on, just like Andrade here tonight. Referee holding back Solo Sikoa as there is a disqualification in this match. Oh, there's a big right hand. And now, nope. Man, it looks like Solo Sikoa has been hitting the mark each time here in this matchup tonight. There's a kick to the midsection, and now, oh, wait a minute, we've seen this before. This time from Solo Sikoa, paying tribute, paying honor to his bloodline here tonight. And of course now, what is Solo Sikoa thinking of doing here tonight? He's heading up to the top. Oh, Roosh is getting up. Roosh is getting up. Wait, what the hell is it? Oh my goodness. Oh, he overshot it. Andrade's telling Roosh to keep going at him. Keep going at him. Catch him. Any time you've got, and that's what Roosh is doing. Fireman's carry, snake eyes in the corner. Big boot to the midsection. No, there's Solo Sikoa with the kick to the gut as well. And now, trying to pick up the pace here tonight as he has him, oh, choked him up on the ropes. Double foot stomp, successfully got it with the kick. And another one, no, avoids that double foot stomp. And now Northern Lights suplex there by Roosh. And whoa, my God, another one. Consecutive ones. Ah, but a rope break there. His bottom foot was under the rope, under the bottom rope there. No biggie though. Here comes a back suplex. No. Solo Sikoa with the reversal. And a kick right to the back here tonight. Look at this. Roosh. Oh no, he gets caught. He gets caught in that. Oh, somehow went drop. He ran and got caught in it. He's going to try it again. What a takedown there from Roosh. Roosh is brave enough to try it again. If I was him, I wouldn't even attempt it again. Here's a chops. Punches there. Solo Sikoa fighting back. Oh, there's a DDT. And you could feel the energy in the arena here tonight. The difference between the two. The clash of styles yet again. Here we go. Oh, diving headbutt. Diving headbutt. And now Roosh is still in trouble, but he kicks out. And there's a stomp right to the arm here tonight. Roosh, man, he's got to go for some. Oh, no. Belly to belly suplex. That's going to put him in quite some trouble. And now has him set up for the solo splash. Here we go. Solo splash there by Solo Sikoa. Two. And wow, a kick out there from Roosh. I wasn't expecting that. And, oh, there's a takedown there from Roosh. Roosh trying to get his offense up here right now, as he should. His defense plays a good, well, game. Oh, diving foot stomp there by Roosh. Can knock the wind right out of Solo, but no. Sikoa kicks out. He has a lot of things to go for here, as Roosh is going to try a numerous amount as he throws down. He throws down Solo Sikoa as he chokes him out there in the center of the ring. He's tired of his antics. Oh, kick to the face. And these two had an interesting clash at Cyber Sunday. I'm glad to see we having this match here tonight. Ducked under the chop. Roosh. Oh, it looked like he got the what? Oh, my God. I think Andrade was distracting the referee off camera that we couldn't see it. And Roosh, a dirty tactic used, but hey, against the Bloodline, I'm calling it fair. I'm calling it even down the middle, damn it. Because Solo Sikoa was about to cost Andrade the title. I deem it as fair. Is he going for, oh my God, the arm in the corner. Oh, Northern Lights. And oh my goodness, double foot stomp, he missed it. The years of experience over Solo Sikoa. Roosh knows exactly what to do and when to do it. Look at this, look at, oh, whoa, whoa. He's gonna go for a high cross there, but no, Solo Sikoa with the slap there, and again, multiple strikes. Enziguri missed it, Roosh, he's ground him. German suplex, no, Solo Sikoa reverses, and gets that arm drag into a neck breaker, beautiful. Sequence by both these men. Belly to belly suplex. Turns them over. Further cover. Further win. For the Bloodline. No. Roosh kicking out. And look at this. Going for the solo splash. And this is it. This is it. Right here. This is the win for the Bloodline. What? Are you freaking kidding me? Solo. Oh. Oh, he gets caught. He gets caught, he crawls to the corner, and Roosh saying it's over. He shouldn't have stayed in the corner. Oh my God. Bull's horns by Roosh. Two, three, and the experience of Roosh beats Solo Sikoa. Come here, Heyman. I need you to deliver a message from you to Reigns, to your tribal chief. Oh my God, no. What the hell? What the hell? No! No! You gotta be kidding me! Oh, there goes Heyman! Hammerlock DDT to Heyman! Ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe we're gonna end the show like this. And he's just dumping him out so he can send the message to Reigns as Andrade and Roosh celebrating. This is how we're gonna end the show. Guys, if you like this episode, please leave a like, share with your friends, and I'll see all of you for Pure Wrestling.